Good evening, everybody. Thank you very much for joining in. This is 49th in the series where we're going to speak about a topic which is known as credit default swaps. Credit default swaps is one of the most important credit risk structure. Is one of the most important derivative that will save the corporate from a credit risk structure. Well, from this side, I'm Rahul Madan, working as a corporate treasurer in EXL Services India. At the same time, I'm also working as a treasury trainer and business consultant for various forums across the world, and also acting as a virtual treasurer for various companies in India. You're most welcome to contact me. You're most welcome to join my LinkedIn group, which is Foreign Exchange Every Thinkers on LinkedIn, which is having 2,200 global members. You are most welcome to join on YouTube, which is having 48 technical videos, 1,250 views and 45 subscribers. You're welcome on Dailymotion as well, and a newly created page on Facebook, which is Foreign Exchange Maverick Thinkers on Facebook. You're most welcome to contact me at 919-899-242-978. You're welcome to email me at rahulmagan8@gmail.com. I'm again stressing on the fact that today we're going to speak about a topic which is known as credit default swap. Post year 2008, in fact, since the start of 2007, when the majority of the world when a set of economists predicted that the world is going to face a crash, which today is known as a mortgage crash. When this 2008 happened, the banks saved their credit risk from an instrument which is known as credit default swap. What do you mean by credit default swap? A credit default swap is nothing but an instrument that will help the buyer to protect the credit risk from the underlying by paying a fixed amount of premium to the seller. The seller is known as a bank. Basically, credit default swap is nothing when a corporate would like to sell or would like to cover the credit exposure on an underlying with a bank by paying a specific premium. I'm again stressing the fact that in post year 2008, credit default swap turned out to be a very important credit derivative instruments in the world of finance. Well, if the statistics are correct, in the today's world, we have the bond structure in the world is roughly 100 trillion, and the total amount of derivative issued in the bond is 710 trillion. So that per dollar bond, you have 7.1x derivatives. Now you can very well estimate that how much important the credit default swap would be. How credit default swap would work? Credit default swap would have two sources. In fact, the two legs. One is known as reference obligation, but is known as payment obligation. Now, theoretically speaking, reference obligation is an obligation on which the credit default swap is based. Now, what is this? Credit reference obligation could be your asset, could be your bond, could be anything. But majority of the time, reference obligation in the international market turn out to be your bond and your any kind of structured product. Please be note that in India, you cannot hedge your so-called receivable, payables and bonds and these kind of things via credit default swap. So you have to go to Singapore market to hedge your credit default swap. This is how a credit default swap is working. Take a very simple example. CDS, or known as credit default swap, would have two legs. One is known as reference obligation, and another is known as payment obligation. Now, the reference obligation would always be an asset, which could be your bond. Majority of the time, it is bond. Now, bond could be your government bond, like we have in the case of Argentina, in the case of Italy, or you can say PIGS. Payment obligation would of two types. One is known as cash, another refers to kind. Kind refers to asset. Now, majority of the time, payment obligation would be cash. So, how a credit default swap would work? Now, how are credit default samples work? I'm going to take a very simple example, and here this example, I'm going to work upon a structure which is known as credit default swap, wherein the reference obligation is a bond. On the other hand, the payment obligation is nothing but a cash. And in this, I'm going to consider an example. The example, take a very simplest example. Assume you have two banks. One is CS, which is known as Credit Suisse. And another is known as GS, which is known as Goldman Sachs. Assuming CS holds a bond, they hold an Italian bonds. And Goldman Sachs act as a seller, CDS seller. Now, CS is having an intent or having a feeling that this bond is going to default. It is going to default. So what CS would do? CS would do what that structure. Assuming the Italian bonds, CS invested in Italian bonds. Assuming the Italian bonds are paying 2.5%. And I'm taking a very simplistic example that the 1 year LIBOR, 1 year dollar LIBOR is trading at 0.58%. Now CS is having a doubt that Italy would default, so they are having one sort of credit risk. What CS would do? CS would act as a CDS buyer. CS, which is Credit Suisse, will go to GS, who would act as a CDS seller, and GS would in turn receive, assuming L plus 100 basis point. So I assume this turnout to be 1.58%. And total, assuming for simplistic reason, assume this is 2.58% which they are earning. So the net gain, net for CS would be 1% in all the senses. Now, here the reference obligation would be Italian bond. The payment obligation would be cash, assuming the deal is of 5 years. Now in this, anytime, if during the period, if there would be a default from Italian government on its security, automatically the contract stand cancelled and Goldman Sachs in return would pay, assuming the total value of bond is $10 billion, Goldman Sachs would pay $10 billion to Credit Suisse in cash, and in return Goldman Sachs would receive that the bonds worth of, say, originally the bond was worth of $10 billion from Credit Suisse. Please be note that once the deal is happening, in case of every swap, the present value of a fixed which is equals to present value of a floating. So once the deal would happen, the value of bond would be 10 billion. Now post the default, obviously there would be a haircut on a bond, and the value of bond would reduce to say 8 billion, 6 billion or on anything, depend upon the haircut. I'm again repeating that credit default swap is nothing but a structure in which you are able to hedge your credit liability. Now in this credit liability, we are assuming that the Credit Suisse is having an exposure on Italian bonds, which is fetching 2.58% of coupon, not the yield. On the other hand, Goldman Sachs is acting as a credit seller, CDS seller. So they are getting a revenue L plus 100 basis point. Assuming 1 year LIBOR stands at 1.58%, so net net they are getting 1.58%. The deal is of 5 years. So within 5 years, if there would be a default, then Goldman Sachs would pay bonds worth of $10 billion to Credit Suisse, and the deal would settle off, and immediately the deal would stand cancelled. Please be note that there is a great difference between credit default swap and interest rate hedging. Interest rate hedging is done to protect your interest rate exposure. On the other hand, CDS is done to protect your credit risk. And in the today's world, when the total amount of derivatives of the bond is $710 trillion, it is predominantly important for corporate treasurer to understand the implication of CDS. And we also saw the technical default by US government somewhere in 2013. So it is pretty much important for us to understand that once we are having kind of credit exposure, then we need to take a CDS. This is all about CDS and how CDS is working and how it should move on. You're most welcome to contact me at 9899242978. You're welcome to email me at rahulmagan8@gmail.com. Thank you for your time and good evening as well.